The government constructed a classroom block, science laboratory, three blocks of teachers' houses and recruited staff members, as Sarah Ayo, the deputy head teacher, explains.
2021, they also recruited the teachers, they recruited the staff members where we have both the non-teaching and the teaching staff. In total, we have 18 teaching staff and 4 non-teaching staff. Not only that, we also have other teachers who are on PTA, and they're also helping us in serving the school. We have students from senior 1 to senior 4. The total enrollment of the school, we have 187 students in the school at the moment. The teachers are teaching tirelessly, and also, as I talk now, we are running UNEP within the school. The school have already processed a center number. So our senior 4 students, our candidates, they're sitting their exams from within the school.
Ayo says they are trying to mobilize more students from the primary schools around to increase the number of students in the school. She has urged fellow leaders to mobilize and sensitize the masses on the importance of educating their children.
This school have just started of recent, from the time of coding, we are trying to do mobilization, but we have not yet reached the extreme. But as the administration, we are trying our best to ensure that we create avenues through advertisement of the school, through reaching to the nearby primary school, so that we can get more students to increase on the population of the school.
Tom Edward Omara, the acting head teacher, says the biggest challenge is lack of electricity in the school.
It's okay. We are moving on well. Right now we are doing UCE exam. Except our only problem now, the biggest challenge we have is electricity. Because we have everything. We have computers. We have computer lab with the 28 computers that the government has supplied. But the problem is now we yet don't have electricity.
Kenneth Ongwech, a student, says the facilities put in the school make it attractive and also provide good learning environment.
Yeah, to see our environment is automatically, you know that, like for the case of this polar being installed, it means electricity is coming nearly. This school, of which will not take a long period of time, will be a modernized school. And everyone who know around and those who may not know, if I'm to convince them, I may say this is a modern school in northern Uganda.
Advising all the PLE students coming after us to come to our school if they want to smile during the end of their studies.
The deputy head teacher has appealed to the government and other stakeholders to fill in the missing gaps to enable them deliver effective service to the students. She has urged residents to enroll their children so that they can have a bright future.
A nearby health facility for referral of our students in case of emergencies. So this is also making managing our health as a school is not easy. I would request if the government could come in through the different stakeholders to help us ensure that most of these facilities that are lacking within the school are brought in place so that it will improve on service delivery within the school.
Seed schools were established by the government in various sub-counties to facilitate the implementation of the Universal Primary Education Program. Story by Hudson Apunyu for the news.